Good morning and welcome to Open Family with Evangelist Snowy Anthony and Eden. God is good all the time. We bless God for keeping us alive to see this beautiful day which He has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. Shouts of victory and rejoicing are heard all the time in the tent of the righteous. We thank God for giving us salvation and Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for reconciling us back to Him through Jesus Christ. We are sinners, we are strayed far from the presence of God. God saw us so struggling with sin, with the bondage of sin, and He sent His Son to this world to deliver us from our sins. We bless Him this morning that He has opened unto us the door through which the righteous must come in. We bless Him this morning that He's standing at the doors of our hearts and is knocking. That if any of us will hear that knock and open the door and open the door, the knock and open the door, He will come in to dine with us. This morning, let our ears be attentive to the voice of wisdom, to the voice of God speaking to us today, that we should turn away from our sinful paths, from the crooked path on which we are walking, to turn back to God in the name of Jesus. He is God, He loves us so much. Amen. He has said nothing can separate us from His love. Let us believe that we are the children of God. That as many that believe in Jesus Christ, that hold on to the truth about the salvation of the gospel of salvation, that God will give them power to become His children. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We will know our God, we are strong for Him, and we do great exploits for Him in the name of Jesus. This morning we have come before that God. Let us close our eyes and offer ourselves before Him this morning. Let us begin to think about His goodness in our lives, in our families, in our communities, about the things He has done for us. Let us bless Him for the salvation He has given to us in His Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us thank God that He has given us power to be His children in this world, to represent Him as the light of this world. Glory, hallelujah, amen. As the salt of this world, that God has given us the privilege to take this gospel of salvation to the nations, to the entire world. Let us thank Him because we have His Spirit in us, the Spirit of God that is working in us and through us to do the will of God. Lift up your hands before God this day, glorify Him, sing a praise unto Him today, a new song of praise unto our God, of His faithfulness, of His love, of His goodness in our lives. He is our God. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, there is no God as thee. You are God alone. We bless you this morning. You have done great and mighty things for us, Father Lord. You have kept us alive to see this day because you still have a purpose for our lives. You want to use us here in this world, Father Lord. We have come to you. We have surrendered everything about us to you this day because we know you are our God. You are great and mighty in the affairs of men. We bless you today in the name of Jesus. Father, we acknowledge that there is no other God as thee. That you are God, Lord, the only true God, the only righteous God, the God who loves us so much, the God who created this world with the spoken word of your mouth. Father, we bless you. Every word you have spoken concerning us and this word, Father Lord, we don't return to you empty. They must accomplish the very purposes for which you have sent them forth. Father, we say thank you. Receive the praise today in the name of Jesus. Receive the praise about God, who is like unto you, Lord God Almighty, among the gods. The other gods were made out of human hands, O Lord God, of the things you created. You are the only one and true God. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We bless you. You preside over the great assemblies of the gods. You are feared among the gods in the mighty name of Jesus. The gods came together. In vain they were gathered. The kings of the earth, Lord God, against you and against your anointed Son, Father Lord. You looked, Father Lord, you saw them and you laughed, Lord God. You heard them, Father Lord, in confusion, the mighty name of Jesus. They do not triumph over you. They do not triumph over your children, Jehovah God. Your counsel concerning us and our nations, Lord God, will prevail in everything relating to us in the mighty name of Jesus. It will be on earth here as it is in heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you for the great and mighty things you are doing this day in the mighty name of Jesus. For flooding us with benefits, Lord God. For anointing our heads with oil. For setting tables before us today. Right in the presence of our enemies, Lord God. We are feeding on those tables. You have invited us to a celebration this morning. We are marching onto the arms of the altar. Even from our homes, Lord God. We are lifting up the banner of Jesus Christ. We are glorifying you, God. You are our God. For your faithfulness to us. Thank you. Hallelujah. Amen. We are not afraid of what the wicked will do unto us this day because we know you defend us, Lord God. You are our shield, Lord God. You are our buckler. You fight our battles for us. Father, you have pulled down every stronghold of the wicked, you are, God. You have made a way for our souls to escape out of the fallen snare in the name of Jesus. This snare has been broken, Jehovah God. We are rejoicing this day in the mighty mighty name of Jesus. Father, receive the praise, receive the honor for the great and mighty things you have already done for us. We are testifying about your faithfulness to our children, Jehovah God, that from generation to generation, Father, Lord, our children will hear about your goodness, Lord God, your mighty power at work in our lives, Lord God, that the things, Lord God, that we did in this world, that we did it through your power in the mighty name of Jesus, that you give us victory over our enemies, Lord God. Father, we bless you. We know that faith comes by hearing, and it is by hearing the word of God. Thank you for giving us instructed tongues, Lord God, to speak as your oracles, Lord God, to our children, to our brothers and sisters in this world, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Our fathers, we have come before you this morning. We acknowledge that you created us to be holy unto you, that standard of holiness can never change, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray that you help us this day, that your grace will be sufficient for us this day, for us to give us the power, oh Lord God, to turn away from our correct path, oh Lord God, to lead them to come back to you, in the mighty name of Jesus. We surrender to your will this day in Jesus' mighty name. Father, help us in the mighty name of Jesus. In ways that we have sinned against you, Father Lord, as individuals, as families, as a nation, Father Lord, nations of people, Lord God, that belong to you, Father Lord, as body of Christ, Father Lord. We ask for forgiveness in the mighty name of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus on ourselves, our families, and our nations, Lord God. We plead the blood of Jesus on the body of Christ to say, Father, have mercy. Forgive us, God. You are God of all compassion, the Father of all mercy. We have not come to you in vain today to ask for forgiveness, God. Father, you are the same God that forgives, Father Lord, sinners, Lord God. You instruct them in your ways, Father Lord. You make them new people in you, in the mighty name of Jesus. You are the only one that can forgive sins, Lord God. You're the God, Father Lord, and can kill and cast into hell, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you this day that you have not condemned us, Lord God, of any wrongdoing. You have forgiven us of all our sins, Lord God. Oh, Father, we bless you because the blood of Jesus has cleansed us and our families and nations, Lord God, from every evil deposit from the kingdom of darkness this day. You are pruning and purging, oh Lord God, and removing from us everything contrary to your will in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we are blessing you, God. You are the only one that can do this for us, Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you this day. As you have forgiven us, we are laying down the feet of Jesus Christ every bitter thought against our brothers and sisters, oh Lord God, every malice, hatred, Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, the spirit of Cain that will make a brother or sister to lift up their hands, oh Lord God, to kill their brothers and sisters, Father Lord. We come against that spirit today in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against the spirit that will make us to discriminate against your children. We come against every hardened spirit, oh Lord God, that will lift up a standard against the word of God today. Father, we are putting everything down at the feet of Jesus Christ here. We receive deliverance today. We thank you that our bones are not being destroyed because of malice and bitterness, oh Lord God. We bless you for the great and mighty things the spirit of wisdom is doing in us this day, that we are attentive to the voice of wisdom, that we are obedient to your will in the mighty name of Jesus. It's not by our power, it's not by our spirit or human will, but by your spirit that we can do the things we do in this world. For this we say, Father, thank you in the name of Jesus. Father, we are blessing for Jesus Christ interceding on our behalf even right now in the heavens. We bless you, Father Lord, Rabba Haba, because he understands the situations that we pass through in flesh and blood. He passed through this world like us, Father Lord, Rabba Haba Haba. Although, Father Lord, Rabba Haba, he passed through difficult challenges here, Father Lord. He did not sin, oh Lord God. In the mighty name of Jesus, he's able to help us, Father Lord. The life that we live today is the life of Jesus Christ. We are blessing you, Jehovah God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We know that the wicked cannot triumph over us and our families, Lord God, that we have been delivered from every evil. Father, receive the praise and honor today in the name of Jesus. We bless you, our Father, in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Our Lord God Almighty, at this time, we are lifting up to you, Father Lord, our families, Lord God. We bless you, Lord God, for our families, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for blessing families, Lord God, for calling us the names that we bear today in this world. We answer in this world today. Father, Lord, you knew us before we were born, before we were in our mother's wombs, Lord God. You knew the families we'll be born into, Father, Lord. We thank you. We bless you, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for giving us the ability to reproduce, Father, Lord, to be fruitful for you in this world, to dominate, Lord God, Rabba Haba Haba, to take control of the things you created, Jehovah God. in the mighty name of Jesus, to multiply, Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. We bless you, God, that we are able to replenish this world in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, God, for the mighty things that we can do for you in this world, because we know you, we are strong, and we do great exploits for you. We bless you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for the spiritual fruit you have laid down, Father Lord, that marriage, Lord God, is between a man and a woman. We bless you that we are holding on to the truth in the mighty name of Jesus, that we have married male to female in the mighty name of Jesus, and that our fevers are full with children in Jesus' mighty name. We bless you, God, that our children are marrying male to female in the mighty name of Jesus. As we pass down the tradition, Father Lord, that we have received from you to our children, we come against every voice, negative voice, Lord God, in our communities, Lord God, every trying to attack the marriage institution, Father Lord. We come against those voices, those negative voices today in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that your children all over the world will be attentive, Lord God, to the voice of wisdom, that they will surrender to your will, oh Lord God Almighty. Have your way in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God. We thank you, God, Father Lord, because we are reproducing and populating this earth with your children, the children that have your spirit in them, in the mighty name of Jesus, those created in your image and likeness, Lord God. Father Lord, we are outnumbering the children of wickedness. We are overturning the devices of the wicked, Lord God, to reduce the human population, Father Lord. You want us, Father Lord, to spread abroad in the mighty name of Jesus, to show your power to every nation, every tribe, everywhere in this world. Oh, Father Lord, where there is life, in the name of Jesus, we bless you, Father Lord, because we are populating the uttermost ends of the world. Oh, Father Lord, your children are coming into your kingdom the way you want it to be, in the mighty name of Jesus, because your goodness is going abroad. The light is shining, oh Lord God, everywhere in the world. Father Lord, is standing firm, oh Lord God, in the sky, like the faithful witness, even like the moon, in the mighty name of Jesus, Rabba Habba, that men, oh Lord God, will be filled with the knowledge of the wisdom of things of God, in the name of Jesus. They will know, Father Lord, what you want them to do. Father Lord, we frustrate the kingdom of darkness this day, everything trying to hold your children in bondage, Father Lord, everything trying to prevent them to enter into that door of righteousness you have opened unto your children today. We come against it by the blood of Jesus and the fire of the Holy Spirit. Jehovah God, right, your word, we come standing against the kingdom of darkness this day. Oh, Father, we bless you in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you. Father, at this time, we are thanking you, oh Lord God, for your children, your sons, our husbands, and our brothers. We bless you, Father Lord, for the great and mighty things you are doing in their lives. We thank you, Father Lord, because they are heads of their families, oh Lord God. We thank you because, Father Lord, they are priests within their homes and in their communities and within the body of Christ, oh Lord God. We thank you because they do not shy away from the things you have called them to do. You ordained them to be priests, oh Lord God. We bless you because they teach their families to pray. They bring their children, Father Lord, up to know you. In the name of Jesus, they demonstrate how to have a fear of you in the hearts of their children, Jehovah God. They show their children how to serve you, Father Lord, in spirit and in truth, Father Lord. We bless you for their good works within their families and communities, oh Lord God. We commit them unto your hands, oh Lord God, that no weapon fashioned against them will prosper, because they have the fear of you in their hearts, oh Lord God. They prosper in the things they do, Father Lord. They are like the tree planted by the riverside that bear its fruit in its season, in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever they do, Father Lord, we prosper. Their leaf will be evergreen forever, in the name of Jesus. Father, we know the wicked are not so. They are like the chaff that the wind is blowing about, oh Lord God. Their path will lead unto destruction, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, we thank you, in Jesus' mighty name. Because your sons, oh Lord God, fear you, Father Lord. You have blessed them with their children, Jehovah God. Their children are like olive shoots around their tables, oh Lord God. Their wives are like fruitful vines within their homes, oh Lord God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, the shouts of victory and rejoicing are heard within their homes, always, in the mighty name of Jesus. They enjoy the goodness of the land, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father Lord, you clothe them in your glory, Jehovah God. In their communities, people see your light, your glory upon their lives, Lord God, and they come to seek wise counsel from them, in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Father, we bless you. Oh, Father Lord, they have desires within their hearts, Lord God, to win souls for your kingdom. Oh, Father, we bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. You are overturning everything the enemy, oh Lord God, has set against them, oh Lord God. They will not stumble, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you will be their God. You are the glory and the lift up of their heads, oh Lord God. Their people have gathered against them and their families, within their families, in their communities, oh Lord God. Father, you are pulling down every stronghold of the wicked, and you are teaching their hands, Lord God, to stand and firmly on the foundations you have laid for them and their families, oh Lord God, as they begin to pull down every stronghold of the wicked, oh Lord God. Father, they are lifting up the banner of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, oh Lord God. We bless you because you are God. You are mighty, oh Lord God. You are back up ocean in the lives of your children. You are involved, oh Lord God, in our affairs here on earth. You help us. You protect us, oh Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Father, we say thank you. thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, we bless you, Father Lord, that our children are good and perfect gifts from you. Oh, Father, you are God of the heavenly light, and there's no variation and that shadow of turning. We thank you for the great and mighty things you are doing in the lives of our children, Jehovah God. We thank you because they prosper in good works, oh Lord God. You are the glory and the lifter up of their heads, oh Lord God. You are restoring back to them everything that belongs to them that the wicked one has tried to take from them. Jehovah God, trying to kill and to destroy. Jehovah God, they did not give life to us and our children. They cannot take our lives. They cannot steal. They cannot take what belongs to us. Father, we lift up a standard against them this day. We say our children are good children. We are sent into a position of authority and influence within their communities, within their families, oh Lord God, and within the body of Christ in Jesus' mighty name. They will grow up. They will become president of nations and head of states, oh Lord God. They will become senators and congressmen in the might and women in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, they will become governors in the mighty name of Jesus. They will become mayors of towns and cities, oh Lord God. Oh, Father, Lord, they will become heads, oh Lord God, of government in the mighty name of Jesus, departments of government in Jesus' mighty name. Jehovah God, in the private private setups, oh Lord God, they will be the heads, oh Lord God, of companies in Jesus' mighty name. You are doing great and mighty things in the life of our children. We bless you, God. You prosper the work of their hands, oh Lord God. You have set, Father Lord, the path on which they will walk on before them this day. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will not stray from that path of righteousness. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will not engage, Father Lord, in corruption in their nations, oh Lord God. Father Lord, we come against every force of darkness. They will not be in courts, oh Lord God, contrary to your will. They will not put one hand in the body of Christ and one hand, oh Lord God, in secret courts, oh Lord God. Father Lord, hold the love of money will not send them, Father Lord, into places they should not go to. In the name of Jesus, Father, teach them how to make money in righteous ways, oh Lord God. Jehovah God, encompass around them. Surround them, oh Lord God, with people who have the fear of you in their hearts, oh Lord God. Jehovah God, we bless you for their lives, oh Lord God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, at this time, Father Lord, we are coming against the spirit of drug addiction and alcoholism. We break you down in the mighty name of Jesus. You cannot have a hold upon the lives of our children. The word of God is lifting up a standard against you. Oh, Rabba Habaha, the fire of the Holy Spirit is descending upon you this day. Oh, Rabba Baba, you evil spirit, the word of God is coming against you this day. The blood of Jesus is speaking against you. Our children are being delivered even right now in the mighty name of Jesus. They are receiving strength to say no to evil in the mighty name of Jesus. Those who go to be our children are to tend them with these evil things, with drugs, oh Lord God, with alcoholism, oh Father Lord, with sex trade and different things, oh Lord God, they are engaging. Jehovah God, separate them from our children. Let the fire come upon their tent, oh Lord God. Let them be shaken. Let the foundation of evil be shaken, Jehovah God. You are God. Arise on behalf of your children. Let your enemies be scattered, oh Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Keep our children safe in the hollow of your hands, oh Lord God. They are your children. We are rededicating them to you, Jehovah God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We are lifting up every institution that you created to you this day, these schools, oh Lord God, anywhere our children are, Father Lord, the Department of Corrections in the mighty name of Jesus, law enforcement, oh Lord God, the judiciary, Jehovah God, the government in the mighty name of Jesus, Father Lord, arise this day on behalf of your children, begin to uproot the foundation of evil in those places, oh Lord God, everyone, Father Lord, in those places that are not working for you, Father Lord, frustrate their counsel this day, oh, confuse them in the name of Jesus, let them be scattered, Jehovah God, and they will not agree on anything in the spiritual realm concerning us and our children in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, uproot from the schools, oh Lord God, everything the enemy has sown there, Jehovah God. Everything the enemy has sown, Father Lord, that is contrary to your will, Jehovah God. Uproot this day in the mighty name of Jesus. Position your children, Father Lord, strategically, Father Lord, to begin to work for you in the schools, oh Lord God, that they will seek you, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus, that they will know, Father Lord, that you have entrusted our children to their care, Jehovah God. Now, Father Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Encompass your children working in the schools, oh Lord God. Give them wisdom, Father Lord. Help them. Keep them safe from the evil ones, oh Lord God, working for Satan within the schools, oh Lord God. In the name of Jesus, you are God. We bless you for the great and mighty things you do this school year, Jehovah God. We are presenting to you those children, Father Lord, that live in families where they have not been taught to love their brothers and sisters, Father Lord. Touch them, Father Lord. Remove the spirit of hatred from your children, Jehovah God. Deliver them, Father Lord, from those places, Father Lord, from their homes, from their families, oh Lord God. Let your spirit penetrate into their hearts, oh Lord God, and begin to instruct them in the things of God. In the name of Jesus, let them receive from their communities the things they need, the love they need, in the mighty name of Jesus. That they'll begin to love their brothers and sisters, oh Lord God. That they will not go to school to begin to attack other people's children, Father Lord. We break the spirit of that spirit that makes children to bully other children in the schools, oh Lord God. Father, let your peace reign in the name of Jesus. That your children will go to school in safety without being afraid, oh Lord God, of their brothers and sisters, oh Lord God. Father, we thank you, we bless you. In the name of Jesus, you are God. God. We are lifting up to you those children who have special needs, oh Lord God. Oh Father, we are committing them into your hands this day. Arise on their behalf and destroy every plan of the enemy to hold them stagnated, oh Lord God. Father, Lord, release, oh Lord God, their blessings upon them and help them, because we know that all the children you created are good and perfect, oh Lord God. Satan, we come against you. The word of God is leading up, we stand against you concerning the children of God this day. They are able to acquire skills to become responsible citizens of their nations and families in the name of Jesus. We are lifting up everyone taking care of them to you this day. Father, we pray that none we abuse or neglect them, Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus. Oh Father, surround them with fire this day in the mighty name of Jesus. That anyone that is trying to do them any evil, that the fire of God will descend upon them, begin to scatter them in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, we thank you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We bless you for the great and mighty things you do in the lives of our children, Jehovah God. Even those, Father Lord, that are within the ages of 0 to 6, oh Father Lord, when they go to daycare, Father Lord, go with them in the name of Jesus. Protect them from evil in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We are crying out to you this day, Father Lord. Hear our cry on behalf of children that have run away from their families, Lord God, that people are using in sex trade and child labor. Jehovah God, we are crying out to you today that they will return back home in the mighty name of Jesus. Shake the places where they are with your mighty power this day. Release those children, Father Lord. Bring to their remembrance, oh Lord God, their families they have run away from, their parents, their brothers and sisters, oh Lord God. Let them return back home in the name of Jesus. Father, you are God, we bless you in Jesus' mighty name for the great and mighty things you do in the midst of your children. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father Lord, at this time we are lifting up to you the Department of Correction. We are praying for those children that are dead and did not do anything wrong. Oh Father Lord, Rabaha, arise on their behalf in the mighty name of Jesus, that their cases will be reviewed, that they will be sent back home in Jesus' mighty name. For those that are dead, Father Lord, under the bondage of drug addiction and alcoholism, Jehovah God, we pray that their cases will be reviewed, Jehovah God, that they will be sent to treatment facilities, oh Lord God, where they will be treated in Jesus' mighty name. Jehovah, we bless you, God, for those who committed crimes in their communities, oh Lord God, that have been kept there, Jehovah God. Father, you are God who can help your children and make them new people in you. Let your spirit go in there and begin to touch them this day in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, help them in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We are lifting up the prison ministries within churches to you, Jehovah God, that they will go into the prisons and jails, oh Lord God, to begin to minister to your children, Jehovah God. We thank you for the great works you do through them, Jehovah God. We thank you that more people will come to you in the mighty name of Jesus. For the salvation of souls, we bless you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. You are our God. We thank you because you love us, oh Lord God. In the mighty name of Jesus, you do not delight in the death of a sinner. You want us to turn back to you from our crooked paths, oh Lord God. In the mighty name of Jesus, help us, God. In Jesus' mighty name, glory, hallelujah, amen. Our Father, Lord, we are blessing you this morning as we commit unto your hands, oh Lord God, our government this day, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, arise on behalf of the nations, oh Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that our government will seek you, Father Lord, in whatever it does, in Jesus' mighty name. We come against us added spirit of disobedience, oh Lord God, in our government, in the name of Jesus. We pray that these principles that you have laid down, Jehovah God, for the nations will not be overturned, oh Lord God, in the government, in Jesus' mighty name. Your children within the government should begin to lift up the banner of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May they not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is your power that gives salvation to men, to those that are perishing this foolishness to them, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father Lord, let them lift up your banner, Jehovah God. Let them give good counsel to the government, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the fear of God come upon them this day, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you have entrusted your children unto their hands, Lord God. May they know why they are in government, in the name of Jesus. Oh Father Lord, may they do good works for you, in the name of Jesus. We are blessing you, God Almighty, for positions that will become vacated, Lord God, by those who have been sitting on those chairs, oh Lord God, that are not working for you. The spirit of fear is gripping them, Jehovah God. They can no longer stand in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Father Lord, because your word will bring them to repentance, oh Lord God. They will live, Father Lord, so that your will can be done in the nations, in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God, that you brought Pope Francis, oh Lord God, to the United States and to the UN, Jehovah God, to speak to the nations, oh Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. May he speak as your oracle, in the name of Jesus. May he not please men, oh Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. May the word coming out from the mouth pierce through the souls and barrels and bones of men, revealing the will of God to us, in the mighty name of Jesus. He will not speak of his own human knowledge, oh Lord God. He will speak as your oracle. We thank you. We bless him, Father Lord. We lift him up to you, Father Lord. Use him to influence the government around the world, in the mighty name Forevermore, let there be a great revival within the church in the mighty name of Jesus. Let things be overturned that contrary to your will. Ordinances of men, tradition of men, Jehovah God, let them be overturned, Father God. Reign in the affairs of men. You are our God. We are blessing you for the reform that is coming, Jehovah God. In the name of Jesus, it has started, Jehovah God. The nations are yours. Father God, you created this world and the fullness thereof is yours in the mighty name of Jesus. You father the world upon the sins, O Lord God, upon the great sins of the waters of the oceans, O Lord God. We are blessing you, Jehovah God, because you have shaken the foundation of wickedness, O Lord God. Even in our government, O Lord God, we are coming against the spirit of corruption in the name of Jesus. The spirit of discrimination that will make a man, one Father Lord, that you created to look at there on the soil of man in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, rise on behalf of your children, Jehovah God, that your children, the needs of your children will be taken care of in the nations in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, that your love will be in the hearts of men. Father, we bless you. If we do not love you, Father Lord, oh, if we do not love our brothers, Father Lord, we have no portion with you. We cannot love you. We cannot serve you, Father Lord. We cannot represent you. We are liars, oh Lord God. If we love you, we will love our brothers and sisters, oh Lord God. Let us be filled with the true love of God for our brothers and sisters this day. In the name of Jesus, wherever we are, let us stand in our rightful positions, oh Lord God, to begin to proclaim the goodness of God, to begin to show your love to the world around us. In the name of Jesus, to begin to take care of our brothers and sisters, oh Lord God, that we do not think about ourselves alone. It's out of fear, oh Lord God, that men think that the great resources, oh Lord God, which you have blessed the world, oh Lord God, will not be enough, will not sufficient for the nations. You have given us more than enough, oh Lord God. There are things we have not even discovered underneath the ocean beds, oh Lord God, underneath the earth, oh Lord God, which you have blessed us, Father Lord. May men not allow fear to allow them to begin to behave irrationally. In the name of Jesus, towards their own brothers and sisters, oh Lord God, we break the spirit, oh Lord God, of wickedness. Father, dwell amongst us and help us in the name of Jesus. Hear our cry this day. You are God in the name of Jesus. We bless you for the great and mighty things you are doing, Jehovah God. Remember, Center of Ahoboshed, that the spirit of this of consideration is falling upon your children. Oh, Father Lord, Rebahama, we are showing mercy to our brothers and sisters because we have received mercy from you, Jehovah God. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, God. In Jesus' name, glory, hallelujah, amen. Father Lord, for the police, oh Lord God, and the judiciary, Father Lord, anyone, Father Lord, not working for you, Father Lord, let their positions become vacated in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, let them repent of their sins, oh Lord God. Let them turn back to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, Rabba, Santa, Rabba, Homo, Shenda, Rabba, Riba, Wobo, Shenda, we bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your children within the police and law enforcement will arise, oh Lord God, that you will send a position of authority in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them walk as for you, Father Lord, and speak as your oracles, oh Lord God, in the nations, in the name of Jesus. Let the love of God be in their hearts towards their fellow human beings in the name of Jesus. Father, we are praying for a cordial relationship between the police and their communities, oh Lord God. We are coming against the spirit of violence in Jesus' mighty name. We pray that the communities will not lift up their hand against law enforcement in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you for the great and mighty things you are doing through law enforcement, Jehovah God. May they be united in one purpose in Christ, oh Lord God. May they go after the terrorists, oh Lord God. Father, give them wisdom, Father Lord, to pursue the terrorists that are coming against your children in the nations, oh Lord God. Help them, Jehovah God, to work for you. Encompass around them with your holy presence. Bless them and their families, oh Lord God. Let them see the face of God in things they do. Oh, Father, let righteousness and justice lead them in Jesus' mighty name. Let the fear of God lead them in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you for every policeman and woman in the name of Jesus. We bless you for their families, oh Lord God. We thank you for the ministry, Jehovah God. We bless you for their good services in the nations, oh Lord God. Thank you, God, for the great and mighty things you will do in their lives, oh Lord God. We thank you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. We pray that the government will take care of their needs, oh Lord God, after they have saved their communities, oh Lord God, after they have defended their nations, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, God, in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, you are our God. We bless you this day, Father Lord. Father Lord, never hammer, hammer. You provide the needs of your children, Jehovah God. We are lifting up to you at this time, Father Lord, our brothers and sisters, oh Lord God, that are married, oh Lord God, that are looking forward to you for the blessings of the womb, Jehovah God. Father, children are inheritance from you. The blessing of the womb is a womb, it's a reward from you. Touch the wombs of your daughters, Jehovah God. Touch your sons, oh Lord God. Wherever the problem is coming from today, we lift up a standard against it in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, bless the wombs of your daughter to carry pregnancies to full term in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you that those children will be born into this world alive. Brothers alive, parents alive, in the mighty name of Jesus. Babies alive. In Jesus' mighty name, we thank you for the dedication of children to you, even now in the spiritual realm, in Jesus' mighty name. It should be done on earth mighty as it is in heaven. We come against the spirit of death that shall burst in Jesus' mighty name. We lift up and stand against the forces of darkness. We break everything that the enemy has tried to do, Father, has done, Father Lord, in our family lines, O Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Father Lord, that we cause any confusion, any sadness, O Lord God, any death of anyone in this generation, Jehovah God. We overturn every curse, O Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we break, O Lord God, every covenant taken against us, O Lord God. And our children, in the mighty name of Jesus, that we have their babies, they will be alive. Oh, Father, we bless you. In the name of Jesus, you have run off, O Lord God, every run of oppression within our family, in families, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every shrine erected, O Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus, that we do not even know about, O Lord God, our ancestors. Oh, they are coming down this day by the mighty power of our God. In the name of Jesus, Father, Lord, in Jesus Christ, everything is perfected. In the mighty name of Jesus, the destiny of any child will not be truncated, Father, Lord, in this generation, in the mighty name of Jesus. We lift up and stand against the forces of darkness, O Lord God, witches and wizards within the families. The word of God is coming against you. So that wickedness in high places, there is spirits of in the universe, we pull you down this day in the mighty name of Jesus. God Almighty has arisen on our behalf this day in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, God, because you are helping us. In the name of Jesus, the weapon fashioned against us and our families will prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we are thanking you for our children that are old enough to be married, that are looking forward to you for the bone of their bones, O Lord God, and the flesh of their flesh, their husbands and their wives, O Lord God. Father, oh Father, Lord, their husbands and wives will come into their lives as you have prayed and said concerning each of them. Father, Lord, we come against, Father, Lord, every word spoken against them, Father, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, they will get married. According to the will of God, we frustrate the kingdom of darkness this day. We are restoring back to them everything that belongs to them in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we bless you, God, because you are doing great and mighty things in the lives of our children, Jehovah God. The enemy will be afraid to come near them. In the name of Jesus, we scatter every work of darkness this day. Father, arise on behalf of your children, Father, Lord. We bless you, God. In the name of Jesus, you are our God. Father, we are blessing you, Father, for the senior citizens, our parents, our grandparents, Lord God. Thank you for their lives. Thank you for what you are doing in them. Thank you for blessing them, Jehovah God. Thank you for using the mighty name, O Lord God, to show your praise to the nations, O Lord God. Thank you for every day to bring us up, Father Lord, that we know you today in the mighty name of Jesus. In old age, let them continue to remain strong, O Lord God, to continue to testify about your faithfulness in the mighty name of Jesus, Father Lord. We pray that you give them a new song, O Lord God, a song of praise, O Lord God, unto you this day in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that none of them will be discouraged, O Lord God, that their children will take care of them in old age in the mighty name of Jesus, that they will remember their parents that took care of them, that brought them up in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, we come against the spirit of abuse and neglect, O Lord God. None we abuse or neglect them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. You encompass around them wherever they are today. Father, Lord, you protect them from evil. We bless you for their good works, O Lord God. Thank you, God, for their lives in the name of Jesus. They are still strong for you. Even now, in the name of Jesus, thank you, God, in Jesus' name. Our Father, we bless you, Father, Lord. We thank you for your goodness. We lift up anyone sick within our families to you, Jehovah God. Those in the hospitals, in the nursing homes, O Lord God. Sick within their homes, O Lord God. Sick in the recovery, in the rehabilitation centers, O Lord God. Oh, Father Lord, those that are in the doctor's hospitals, O Lord God. Wherever they are today, we commit them unto your hands, O Lord God. Even those that do not have roofs upon their heads, O Lord God. Father, arise on behalf of your children today. Send your word, O Lord God, of healing to them in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, by the hands of the wicked, O Lord God, trying to attack your children, Jehovah God. We come against various sicknesses and diseases, Father Lord, destroying the body, cells, and blood of your children. Oh, Father, flush out from the bodies of your children with the blood of Jesus today. Everything that is not of you, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we pray for perfect healing, Jehovah God. You have a good plan for us. You want us to prosper, Father Lord. You want us to be in good health, Lord God. You want our souls to prosper, Jehovah God. In the name of Jesus, we are pulling down the stronghold of the wicked, sicknesses, and diseases. We are coming against you by the blood of Jesus today, by the living word of God. Oh, the fire of the Spirit of the living God is descending upon your tent this day. Oh, the children of God have been delivered this day in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we are blessing you because you are doing great and mighty things in the life of your children. Father, you are encompassing around their hospital beds wherever they are today with your holy presence, Jehovah God. You are lifting up and standing against the forces of darkness, Lord God, in the medical field, Lord God. Those who are testing for blood, the word of God is coming against you. Oh, Rabba Santa Rabba Haha. You are being confused right now by the word of the living God in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is speaking against you this day in the mighty name of Jesus. The fire of the Spirit of the living God is descending upon your tent this day. You have been scattered. You cannot agree in the spiritual realm or anything concerning the children of God. Father, let your children within the medical profession upon. Release wisdom upon them, Father Lord. Flood them with wisdom this day. Oh, with great benefits, blessed Jehovah God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Surround them with your holy presence and protect them from the evil one, switching the profession, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, hold your hands, O Lord God. Let your hands, O Lord God, be blessed this day. That they lay their hands upon your children, Jehovah God. Your children will receive healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Jehovah God, we pray for breakthroughs, O Lord, breakthrough in medical science, O Lord God, in the treatment of various diseases and sicknesses attacking your children, in the name of Jesus. We know, Father Lord, that there is cure for some of those illnesses and diseases in this world, even right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, those who know, Father Lord, let them begin to reveal the things you have taught them, in the mighty name of Jesus, to the nations, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father Lord, we pray that we discover the things you have placed in this world to bless us. Help us, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we bless you. We lift up every medical equipment used in the laboratories, in the hospitals, oh Lord God, in nursing homes, oh Lord God, in the rehabilitation centers. We dip them in the blood of Jesus, that everything will begin to function and right. We come against the spirit of false diagnosis, Father Lord, of illnesses and sicknesses. Your children will not receive treatment for the things they do not have. Father Lord, they will receive treatment and they will be cured of things that they have, in the name of Jesus. Father, you are God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We bless you, God. We lift up all the laboratory technicians to you, Jehovah God, all who do various tests and on behalf of your children, Jehovah God. We come in there unto your hands, O Lord God. Anyone working for Satan, frustrate them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, prevail in the matters of your children, Father, in the name of Jesus. Our Lord and our Father, we thank you, God Almighty, for medicine, Father Lord, that your children have manufactured, O Lord God, to cure various diseases and sicknesses, O Lord God. We pray that they will be available to your children, Jehovah God. We come against them, Father Lord, that are producing fake medicines, oh Lord God, poison, and putting them in the markets, oh Lord God. Father, arise on behalf of your children and hold them back in Jesus' mighty name. Let the fire of God descend upon their factories in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them repent of their sins, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus. You are God. Father, we bless you. You are doing great and mighty things on our behalf, even right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we have not prayed in vain today. You have come to us. You have helped us, Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, God, for what you are doing within the body of Christ, oh Lord God. We thank you, Father Lord, because you are stopping, Father Lord, the devices of the enemy, all the false prophets and teachers that have come amongst us, oh Lord God. We are pushing back against them, Father Lord. We are pressing against them this day. We are pressing unto the high calling of God in Christ Jesus in each one of us, in the mighty name of Jesus. We are trampling upon their devices this day, Father Lord. We are frustrating them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, they think about their bellies alone. They do not care about the salvation of souls, oh Lord God. They do not care about your children, Jehovah God. They are not calling your name, oh Lord God. Father, we come against them this day. Lift up a standard against them. Let them be frustrated. Let them be scattered in the name of Jesus. Father, we come against every spirit contrary to your will within the body of Christ this day. We are praying for the spirit of discernment upon your children, Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus. That each one of us, oh Lord God, we stand in our rightful position within the body of Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus. That we begin to use our spiritual gifts to bless the kingdom, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. We thank you for spiritual fathers and leaders, oh Lord God, that will not compromise the living word of God. We thank you that your word is active in their lives, oh Lord God, that they are holding on to the truth, oh Lord God, and they are teaching their assemblies the truth, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Father, let them continue to speak as your oracles, oh Lord God. Father, bless them. Lift up their heads, oh Lord God. Put them in the forefront of everything relating to your kingdom, your on earth, in the name of Jesus. Encompass around them and their families with your holy presence, God. Put down every plan of the enemy to discredit them, oh Lord God. One, Father, we come against every spirit of the enemy, every burden the wicked is trying to cast upon them this day. Jehovah God, we thank you for their lives. Their children are blessed, their wives are blessed, their husbands are blessed, in the name of Jesus. They will continue to do great and mighty works for you, Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for their lives, oh Lord God. Thank you for the great and mighty things you do through them today, in the mighty name of Jesus. We bless you, God, for fresh anointing, outpouring of fresh anointing upon them, Father Lord. We thank you for the spirit of gladness upon them, in the mighty name of Jesus, that their hearts are being gladdened even right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you that they are fruitful for you because they have remained in Christ Jesus. They study your word, oh Lord God. They feed on it. they meditate on it and they pass it on to their congregations in the mighty name of Jesus. They are fruitful, Father Lord, in the things they do, because Father Lord, they seek your face all the days of their lives. Oh Father, they are strong pillars within the body of Christ, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus. They support missions around the world. We bless you, Father Lord, for the great and mighty things you are doing through them, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Father Lord, the world will come to know that they are truly your children, Jehovah God. Their voices will be heard clearly because they speak as your oracles. They are not afraid of what the world will do unto them. Father, we say thank you, in the name of Jesus. You are God. Oh Father, we bless you this day as we lift up the mission field to you. We thank you for your children that have gone forth into the mission field. Oh Father, we thank you because your word is a lamp unto their feet and a light unto their path, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Father, we thank you because signs, wonders, and miraculous things have gone ahead of them, and with them, Father Lord, wherever they are going today, your light is shining through them to the nations, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus. You have returned the captivity, oh Lord God. Oh Father Lord, Rabba Papa Shanda, you have released them, oh Lord God, from every plan of the enemy, oh Lord God. You have lifted up and standing against the forces of darkness, oh Lord God, those owning the four winds of the world. You are bringing them down, Father Lord, that your children will be able to go out into the nations, to penetrate into those dark places, oh Lord God, of the world, to bring souls into the kingdom, in the name of Jesus. People are waiting, Father Lord. The word must get to them, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the good works, oh Lord God. Those in chains, oh Lord God, Father Rabaha. Your word says, oh Lord, Father Lord, that blessed are those that are persecuted for righteousness' sake. They are blessed, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Their good work we speak on their behalf, in the mighty name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is speaking for them right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. They are being delivered, and chains are being broken right now by the power of God, in the name of Jesus. Oh Father Lord Rabaha, the spirit of the living God, arise. Let the spirit of God descend upon the tent of the wicked this day. Oh, let the fire of the living God descend upon the tent of the wicked this day. Let the captivity be overturned, in the mighty name of Jesus. Release us, children. You are God. We bless you. You are doing great and mighty things, Father Lord. Thank you for the huge harvest of souls around the world. Thank you for souls that are coming to the kingdom. Thank you for people renouncing foreign religion, Father Lord. People that are coming to know you, Father Lord. Well, Father, we bless you. You are God, in the name of Jesus. We bless you for the intercessors around the world. We lift them up to you, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for strength, Lord God, to pray. We thank you for wisdom, Father, you've given to us to wait on you. We thank you, Lord God, for your grace that helps us, Lord God. We thank you because you have refreshed us, Lord God. We thank you because we do not pray in vain, and we pray in accordance to your will, because your spirit helps us in our weaknesses. Spirit of the living God, pray for us this day, in the mighty name of Jesus. Overturn every plan of the enemy against us and our families. Overturn them. Wherever they are gathered, wherever they are dug, they pit, let them fall into their own pit, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Father Lord, protect us and our families as we lift up the nations to you, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. You are our God. Receive the praise, receive the honor for the great and mighty things you are doing in our lives, oh Lord God. We thank you, God. We lift up various situations to you, Jehovah God, that your children find themselves in today. Father, we are meeting you at the elevation of beauty today. Make everything beautiful in the lives of your children. Those morning touch them, reassure them of your love, of your presence in their situations, Jehovah God. We thank you for the loved ones that are passing to eternal rest, in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't struggle with the challenges of life, Jehovah God. Touch them this day. Reassure them that you are present in their situations, oh Lord God. That you are God. That you have made everything beautiful for your children in this world. That the barren lines are falling on us in pleasant places, God. That we have a good inheritance in you. That you have given us the fat of the nations, oh Lord God. Father, we bless you, God. That you have given us your peace, oh Lord God. Not as the world giveth, oh Lord God. In the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ says that we should not allow our souls to be bothered. That we should not be worried about any cares and worries of this world. In the name of Jesus. That we should place our burdens on him, Jehovah God. That he has gone to his father's house, oh Lord God. That in his father's house are many mansions. That if you're not so, he would have told us that he has gone ahead of us to prepare the place that where he is, there we will be. In the name of Jesus. We believe that he has given us peace, oh Lord God. We have entered into your peace this day. We thank you, God, for the great and mighty things you have done on our behalf today. We bless you for answering our prayers this day. As we go into the study of your word this day, enlighten our eyes, oh Lord God. Let us feed on the living word of God today. Let our word be active in our lives, oh Lord God. Let it produce the fruit of righteousness in each one of us, oh Lord God. As we have received a field this day, oh, the living word of God and wisdom, Jehovah God, may we begin to distribute it our right, oh Lord God, to the people around us without holding back any. In the name of Jesus, that men, oh Lord God, will be filled with the knowledge of your will, Jehovah God. Because faith comes by hearing, and it is by hearing the word of God. Glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless you, God. We send a praise and honor today for what you have done. You are God. There's no God at sea. Thank you, Father, Lord, for helping us Tuesday. Thank you for being our Father Tuesday. In the name of Jesus, you are always our God. Thank you, God. You help us, oh Lord God. In the name of Jesus, receive the praise and the honor. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have prayed. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May our God be exalted in our lives since He is our God. He will never fail us in the name of Jesus. Yes, we do not lack anything good. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen. This morning, I want to read Psalm 94. I will read from verses 1 to 15 this morning. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Psalm 94. O Lord, the God who avenges, O God who avenges, shine forth. Rise up, O judge of the earth. Pay back to the proud what they deserve. How long will the wicked, O Lord, how long will the wicked be jubilant? They pour out arrogant words. All the evildoers are full of boasting. They crush your people, O Lord. They oppress your inheritance. They slay the widow and the alien. They murder the fatherless. They say, the Lord does not see. The God of Jacob pays no heed. Take heed, O take heed, you senseless ones among the people. You fools, when will you become wise? Does he who implanted the ear not hear? Does he who formed the eye not see? Does he who disciplines nations not punish? Does he who teaches men lack wisdom, lack knowledge? The Lord knows the thoughts of man. He knows that they are futile. Blessed is the man you discipline, O Lord, the man you teach from your law. You grant him relief from days of trouble. Glory. See, a pit is dug for the wicked, for the Lord will not reject his people. He will never forsake his inheritance. Amen. Judgment will again be founded on righteousness, and all the upright in heart will follow it. Judgment will again be founded on righteousness, and all the upright in heart will follow it. That the Lord will not reject his people. He will never forsake his inheritance. Faithful God. We are serving a faithful God. His unfailing love. We never leave us in despair. In the mighty name of Jesus, He helps us. He fights our battles. He pulls that every stronghold of the wicked. You must believe that God is able to help us. Whatever situations we find ourselves in today, let us come to God, the God that can help us. Let us lift up our voices and begin to cry out to God from our afflictions. God hears the cry of His children. He comes down to see what is happening and to deliver us. He sends his angels to deliver us. As we have been reading about Sodom and Gomorrah, he sent the angels there. He heard the affliction of the children of God crying out to him. Then he sent the angels to go and see what was happening in Sodom and Gomorrah. And of course, when they got there, those wicked people wanted to sleep, have sex with the angels of God. So, it was first-hand experience with evil in Sodom and Gomorrah, not just the outcry of the children of God. God still does it this day. He comes down. His eyes go through and through the universe. He's seeking those that are righteous, those who know Him, those who care about the things of God. The wicked may think that God who created the eye does not see, God who created the ear does not hear, that God who gave us hands cannot feel, that God who gives us wisdom has no knowledge. God who helps us does not care about us, who created us. But we, the children of God, that have the Spirit of God in us, we that know our God, we know that our God hears our outcry to Him from our afflictions. That God comes to deliver us from the proud and the arrogant. Amen. And we know that our God is merciful and that is giving men time to repent of their sins. That the cup of evil of the wicked one will be full if they do not repent of their sin. And when it is full, that the wrath of God in his full strength will come against them in the mighty name of Jesus. God is allowing them, giving them time to repent. But they are filling their cup with their evil. They are enjoying it. They are filling their bottle, whatever is in their hands. But God has given us our lot and our portion. He has given us our cup. He said there's a cup in the wicked eye. And that the great cup, that what is in there is filled with mixture of bitter wine. Bitter mixtures because of their evil in the mighty name of Jesus. But we drink sweet wine. Amen. Everything God has given to us is to help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Springs of living water will overflow from our bellies. So when the wicked triumph in their evil deeds, do not be bowed at. Do not allow fear to come into your heart. Do not be burdened by their evil. Lift up your eyes to God and begin to cry out to God. That, Father, see what is happening around me. The way the people that cried out to God in Sodom and Gomorrah did. Lot was there. Amen. God who keeps his covenant to his children. God came to deliver Lot from that evil that was in Sodom and Gomorrah in the mighty name of Jesus. We read a little about that this morning. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Let's see how far we can go. Amen. I'm continuing from a study of Genesis chapter 19 in the name of Jesus, beginning from verse 18. Yesterday we read that even when the angel told Lot to leave Sodom and Gomorrah with his wife and daughters and with his son-in-laws, the son-in-laws thought that he was joking. Lot heard what the angels told him, but at the time he was about to go, he was reluctant, he was hesitant in his spirit. Our merciful God made the angel to grasp his hand and the hand of his family and actually drag them out of Sodom and Gomorrah. That's what God does for us. We do not want to do what God wants us to do. Because God is merciful, God still helps us. He drags us, not by human being, by his spirit. The Spirit of God enables us to do the things we do. You just find out that, oh, you didn't want to do something, that suddenly you just started doing it. Give glory to God. Praise him. It's by the Spirit of God that we are able to do the things we do. Not through our own human effort, not through our own human will. The angels are still holding us and dragging us away from things evil and making us to turn back to that path that God has laid for us. That's why wisdom is crying all the time to us, because we are the children of God. The seal of his ownership is upon our lives. As we have accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, God will help us. When we sin, let us come back to God and repent of our sins so that we do not fall out of line with God. We don't allow anyone to cut in front of us to be out of step with the Spirit of the living God that is leading us through this world in the name of Jesus. We must press on to the high calling of God in Christ Jesus in each one of us. It's a determination within us. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Today we are going to read. We will see how Lot exercises free will, the free will that God gave to us. When he was brought out from Sodom and Gomorrah, the angels told him to flee to the mountains. Quickly, he and his family to the mountains, so that they will not be destroyed, along with Sodom and Gomorrah. But Lot turned and told him that, please, can I go to this small town or village that is nearby, instead of fleeing to the mountain? Can I go there? And his wish was granted. And the angel said, go to that small village. If he had gone to the mountain, perhaps he would have gotten to the mountain before sunrise. His wife would not have been able to turn back to see Sodom and Gomorrah being destroyed. Because the wife turned back and she became a pillar of salt. The angel said, do not turn back, flee for your life, run into the mountains. But we always want to use human wisdom to solve situations. That why can I go to the mountains? In the mountains, there's no vegetation, nothing. There's all vegetation, all trees, nothing. I can see houses, I can see anything. There's a small village here. Let me go to this village. Because of him, that village was spared. But Sodom and Gomorrah, all the plains, all the towns in the plains were destroyed. Amen. But God remembered Abraham and he saved Lot in Jesus' mighty name. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. So we continue with the reading. Glory. Verse 16, Genesis chapter 18. But Lot said to them, no, my lords, please, your servant has found favor in your eyes, and you have shown great kindness to me in sparing my life. But I can't flee to the mountains. This disaster will overtake me, and I will die. That's the way we think. God is telling you, run to the mountain. The God who told you to run to the mountain, that God has given you abundant life, his grace is sufficient for you, he will take care of you in the mountain. Amen? But what did Lot say? He said that he will die if he runs to the mountain. That's the way we think. We almost have spiritual eyes to see. We must be able to perceive what God is going to do for us in our spirit, to believe God, to trust God. If God says, go to the mountain, let us go to the mountain, because God will be there to help us in the mountain, in the name of Jesus. But I can't flee to the mountains. This disaster will overtake me and I will die. Look, here is a town near enough to run to. And it is small. Let me flee to it. It is very small. Isn't it? Then my life will be spared in that town. Yes, his life was spared, but his wife became a pillar of salt because she turned back. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Then he said to him, very well, I will grant this request too. I will not overthrow the town you speak of, but flee there quickly, because I cannot do anything until you reach it. So there was a delay in carrying out the assignment that God gave to the angels because of Lot, who wanted to go to the town that was nearby. So from what we are reading, obviously the mountain was closer for him to have gone to, run to, in the mighty name of Jesus, but he wanted to go to that town. That's in the first place. He chose the plains because it was beautiful, it was pleasing to his eyes. Amen? To be in the plains. Now he's choosing a town instead of going to a place that was quicker for him to get to, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us be attentive to the voice of wisdom in Jesus' mighty name. It may not look good. We may not like it. It may not make sense to our human reasoning. But when God says it, let us be obedient to God in Jesus' name. Amen. Now look, here is the town. I'll continue. Let me flee to it. It is very small, isn't it? Then my life will be spared. He said to him, very well, I will grant this request too. I will not overthrow the town you speak of, but flee there quickly, because I cannot do anything until you reach it. That is why the town was called Zoar. By the time Lot reached Zoar, the sun had risen, amen, over the land. Then the Lord rained down burning sulfur on Sodom and Gomorrah from the Lord. Sodom and Gomorrah from the Lord, out of the heavens. Thus he overthrew those cities and the entire plain, including all those living in the cities and also the vegetation in the land. But Lot's wife looked back and she became a pillar of salt. Do not look back means do not look back. Lot's wife looked back and she became a pillar of salt. The sun had risen. She was able to see the city she left. She was still thinking about that city, but she became a pillar of salt. When God speaks to us, we must carry out every detail to the last letter in Jesus' mighty name. We pray that the Spirit of God will help us in the name of Jesus. That early the next morning, Abraham got up and returned to the place where he had stood before the Lord. He looked down towards Sodom and Gomorrah, towards all the land of the plain, and he saw dense smoke rising from the land, like smoke from a furnace. So when God destroyed the cities of the plain, he remembered Abraham and he brought Lot out of this catastrophe that overthrew the cities where Lot had lived. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Imagine Abraham waking up in the morning and looking towards the plain cities and seeing that dense smoke arising from the city. We can imagine what went through his mind, what he was thinking about. At that time, he did not even know that Lot had been delivered. We can imagine in his happiness when he found out that God kept his covenant to him, that God saved Lot because of Abraham. That's what God does for us. He said that we and our families will be saved. Let us believe God and continue to pray and lift up our families before God. He is God that keeps his covenant. He will never fail us. He has spoken good things concerning us and is able to do those things in the mighty name of Jesus. We believe every word God has spoken concerning us and our families. We bless him because he's our God. At this time, we are lifting our hands to bless God, to thank him for his living word that we have fed on today. We thank him because he has eyes to see our situations. He has ears to hear us, so we cry out to him. We thank him because Jesus Christ passed through this world and he fed everything that we feed today. When he was in this world, he understands our situations. He's able to help us. When we come to him with our petitions, with our prayers, supplications, and requests, he's able to help us in our afflictions. Father, we bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you keep your covenant, so Lord God. We are your children. You are giving us a measure of faith each to believe in you. We thank you that we are adding good works to our faith, Lord God, as we meditate on your word and we feed on it. We believe that every word that we study will produce the fruit of righteousness in us, that we have more faith to trust you, to work for you, to do greater things for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for being our God. Thank you for refreshing us this morning. Thank you for the living word that we have fed on. Thank you for the spirit of wisdom speaking to us. Thank you, Lord God, for our church families, Lord God, for our spiritual fathers and leaders, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for the Pope, Lord God, Pope Francis, Lord God. He will continue to speak as your oracle in the name of Jesus. He's going to do great and mighty things, even within the Roman Catholic Church, Lord God, within the body of Christ, Lord God. Many people will come, Lord God, oh, Rabba, to the kingdom, Lord God. Many souls will come because of him in the mighty name of Jesus, even from Islam and various religions, Jehovah God. Many people will come, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus because of the things he's going to do, the things he's going to say, Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. He's going to touch the hearts of men, Jehovah God. Oh, speak through him, Jehovah God. We are blessing you, Jehovah God. You are doing great and mighty things around the world. We bless you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you that we are all united as one. Oh, Father Lord, in the spirit of Jesus Christ, Lord God. In your spirit, Lord God, we are all united, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we bless you because we are yours, Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, have your way in our lives. Thank you, Lord God, for the unity of the Spirit, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus, within the body of Christ. We thank you that it's when we are united that you bestow the blessings upon your children. Thank you for blessing the body of Christ. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, for your children that speak as your oracles, Lord God. Thank you for your children that seek to do your will. Thank you for the huge harvest of souls around the world. Thank you, God, for everything you have done today. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have worshiped. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May our God be exalted in our lives this day. In Jesus' mighty name. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. You are blessed. God loves you. We love you too. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen.